Hello, everyone. You know who this is. Yet you have absolutely no idea. Of course.
Wow. Somebody gonna be famous. Real famous.
I sit here writing to you now with my exceptionally long penis buried deeply and warmly into my vagina butt.
Isn't that neat?
Troy Hunter 77 has joined the game.
Call 911. This place needs to be swatted if I'm not gonna...
You have a bully headband.
You don't find people being bullied into suicide on 4chan.
I mean, this is ridiculous.
Okay, if he says any more bad words, I'm gonna hang up on him. He doesn't own Kiwi Farm, and he tries to lie to me. A little kid named Moon owns Kiwi Farm.
Stay! The fuck! No!
How do they make this more and more epic every time?
We're all defending ourselves!
I'm sorry, I'm a soy-filled bitch and like your videos.
If we get Donald Trump just to tweet out, I mean, you know, just a tweet that mentions the hashtag GameGate, it doesn't even necessarily matter how you use it. Man, the blue check marks are going to shit their fucking hats.
It's 2019, I can't believe anybody believes in a spinning fucking ball of water.
True. I bet you when Jim finds out, he's gonna just give me so much shit.
One never knows when the homosexual is about.
I've had over 1,000 rejections in real life, 2,000 rejections online, so that's 3,000 rejections total. I aim as low as possible. I aim for obese women, ugly women, ideally ugly and obese. I would do anything just for a 300-pound ugly white girl.
I said, it's not even hot.
You are not allowed to bring her to the hospital. No. No, you get no permission to fucking do it.
You gotta be kidding. It's just like this declaration. This declaration. Right? Of male dominance.
Yeah, put that in your pipe.
I definitely cheated on Super Mario with Sonic the Hedgehog.
Stop doing this stuff.
He's like the blue seductress who takes me out into the night and does wonderful things to me.
Enough! Stop!
How can a Yorkshire Terrier live in the wild? It's in plain sight, but you just don't see it. You know what I mean?
Well, rise and shine, my little chud butts. I'm seeing some people complaining about lag. Welcome to Odyssey, the future of streaming. Hopefully, we get that taken care of. Oh, I've already got real money. I thought it was oodles for a minute. It's actually really money. How are you enjoying Autism in the Shadow, or Eminence in Shadow? Also, can I get a Nerds Rise Up? You can get a Nerds Rise Up. All the Nerds rising up. We all love it. And yes, I did see the first episode. A little bit of a bait and switch. Had people a little confused. Turned out to be pretty fucking great for an opener. Even more. Rest in power, little moon cricket from Urza Mikan. All right. Oh, there we go. Finally, fake money for you. Thank you. I can't cope without my oodles. Without my Beelzebubs. Beelzebubs. Beelzebucks. I need that money. I need those oodles. We got a lot of nerds in chat right now. Welcome to my 660 Andy show. We'll see where we are at the end of it. Oh, lots to go over. Lots of people saying 480p is the way. I used all their settings, so I'm not sure. Maybe Julian's a little upset with me about all those Moloch jokes the last time. I mean, that is possible. I made a whole bunch of them, and I've got even more today. Just tons and tons of Moloch jokes that are never gonna end. In fact, we've got a little bit of a fight that took place between Ethan. Well, there's always. Is it a surprise if I bring up the name Ethan Ralph and then it's followed by a fight that took place over on Twitter? Oh, he a hootin' and a hollered. He's stomping around in a truffle hunting, just like the fat bitch he is, he deleted everything. Scared little motherfucker. Maximum fun posting for 0.01 oodles. Dildo Nixon, good morning. Can you tell us where Bibble took that shit and is someone mistaken it for a Star Wars toy? It's possible Michael Alberto might have mistaken it for a Star Wars toy. I'm not 100% certain. From what I understand, as I was telling the chat earlier, poor Bibble is in county lockup right now. It's a very sad and tragic fucking story. I don't know if you know this, but he loves D&D. You know, typical black guy activity, right, chat? Loves D&D. Lives for it. Fifth edition, only edition he'll play. Well, somebody asked him to be the DM. He thought it meant they had said BM. And he just dropped his pants and took a deuce right in the toy aisle of a Walmart. So now he's in county lockup. It's shameful. It's sad. Can't even make bail because you can't pay bail in food stamps, can you, Bibble? So he's going to be gone for a little while. Maybe, you know, Ralph can detour off his trip to go visit Ali Jamal for his midlife crisis sleepover slumber party and bail Bibble out for taking a shit in a Walmart. I don't know. Was Bibble invited to the sleepover? Chat, are you... I don't know. Chat, was Bibble invited anywhere? Has Bibble ever been invited anywhere? How can you host a midlife crisis slumber sleepover party without the LARPing black guy? It's not going to be very fun. You're going to miss out on so much entertainment. No one will notice he's missing. He just blends into the background. Bibble was not invited? Oh, that's heartbreaking. From PP Poo Poo, Bibble is a fruitcake loser. Thank you for your oodle. 0.1 oodles from HR HTR to you. Oh, no, no. Acer Thorn is going to become like David Shitrat was. It's going to be the ever chased dream of a stream until it finally just fucking happens. From Bob Rob, Nick Fuentes is a homosexual leader of a catboy grooming cult. What? Guys, you're being a little mean here. Sir Anti-Nipper Bully, fantastic name. Bibble roll a D20 to evade getting raped in the showers. By the way, folks, I need to tell you, you need to be warned. All right, we're dropping a lot of N-bombs over here, a lot of Nipper and chat. Okay, Augie and Tom, they're under the gun right now. They're in big trouble. Okay, because they associated with me, and I use the N-word. They may play games and play sound clips of Keemstar saying, Nipper, but I'm actually using it in a live stream these days. So when you guys start spamming in chat, you get Augie and Tom in a lot of trouble. I would hate for somebody to say that they fully endorse this stream. Augie, RFC, and Turkey Tom fully endorse this stream and then screenshot chat just screaming nonstop, nonsensically. It makes no sense. Why would you say this many times? Who just donated money to say on this platform? Augie, Tom, what are you doing? These are all Augie and Tom's fans that have been sent over to my chat and they just keep spamming because of our deep, deep bond and close association. Please don't tell Bibble and Ethan Ralph that Augie and Tom avow this and then we're just crazy for n****s over here. Have I hit my quota? We're only a few minutes into the stream. How many times can I say n****, chat? I don't know. Ezra Mikan just bombed us with a n**** donation. His precious little pennies are just, I can hear him filling up the piggy bank right now. Oh, we've got knocking. We've got a lot of n**ks in chat today, chat. Oh, boy. Oh, I need to start the stream off like I always start a stream off by shilling because I'm a fucking whore. Don't forget to go to the merch store. Oh my god, it's Selfied. Buy things. Now, I can't brand any of those shirts that say n**. And I'll have to find a clever way of doing moon cricket, too. However, I do have a depressed son smoking a cigarette for Mornings with Metokur. Isn't that adorable? Isn't that a fun conversation to have? Why is that son so sad? What is Metokur? Why are you wearing that pink shirt to the office, Bill? Do you want to be fired? I don't understand it. Your productivity's been down lately. And you're wearing these branded shirts. I don't know what they mean. And you keep screaming at me. I don't know if HR is going to like this. Okay? I mean, the shirt's one thing and calling me a n**** is another. But you also said you were going to fuck my wife. And really, I don't think that's appropriate in the workplace. I'm going to have to involve HR. I'm going to have to... HR's going to have to get involved. Chat, you know, it's been a lot of sad news. Oh, chat, it's been tragic lately. Oh, 800 Andy. Welcome to the 800 Andy Show over on Odyssey. We're crawling our way up through the dirt. A lot of sad news, though, this week. I don't know if you can all give me a moment of silence for Beardson Beardley, who's, I think, departed from this world. I had this shared with me by my very good friend, by which I mean myself. Caught it live. Didn't. Caught it live like I guess he caught that self-inflicted bullet. Breaking fucking news from Beardson Beardley. It's over, folks. He recently did a live stream. You can read the title. Those people over at Cozy are fucking crazy. Finally killing myself. And his chat was not very sympathetic. I don't think they're very nice people over there. These aren't very nice. It's so sad. It's tragic. I mean, if you read those comments, Catholic Aussie, I think that's one of his mods. I legit always hated you? From Free Gucci, use a rope like a real man. Guns are for pussies. We got one there. Burn in hell, jerking it to your death. Fruitcake, burn in hell. Hobbit, added a little bit of a difference there. Do it, you fucking fruitcake. Eat the gun. No one will miss you. Look at the camera when you pull the trigger, for real. Should have done this sooner, fruitcake. Heartbreaking. Chat, this is sad. I think Beardson's dead. I think he finally did it. He's been threatening it for a long time, ever since his ex-wife was getting banged by black dudes. Maybe that's why he has such an obsession with Yeezys. You know how they're like, the look makes the man? And since his wife was looking at black dick, he thought, I need to get black shoes. Give me some Yeezys. Nick, I need fashion advice. Those trash bags that you got from Kanye West, can I borrow some? So maybe I can get her to come back to me, because I'm so fucking lonely over here, man. It's finally time to kill myself on Cozy.tv. Is that a possibility? I don't know. Oh, the wall just said, just because Jim says Nick doesn't mean he hates you. He loves Nick. It's very true. She fucked a moon cricket. Somebody got to create audio of crickets just going off with Beardson sobbing in the background. Just every one of his streams, you hear crickets in the background, and nobody at Cozy understands what that means. Because they never leave that little hug box. Oh, poor Beardson. Rip. Rip in peace, buddy. I loved you in The Hobbit. I thought you would have saved money from those movies, but I guess not. It's tough for a little guy out there, isn't it? Oh. Let's see. Let's dedicate exactly 1 minute to this. This is just a fantastic compilation of two screenshots, like a before and after. It's like it's the corporeal form of Biz. If Biz substantiated in the real world, like it just broke through reality from another dimension, this is what it would be. I love it. I'm finally rich. How I made my crypto money, how it made me rich. And then I need your help. This is every Biz. It's not even like Biz needs a year to do this. It's like every thread on Biz. This is what it is. I'm gonna drive a Lambo. I'm going to be so fucking rich. And then 5 minutes later, I'm fucking broke, guys. I look at all the money. Look how happy he is up top, and now he's fat and sad and broke in the bottom. Do you think he spent any of his fucking money on his house? Or is he complete fucking retard? Oh, real money. Let me run to that. From Alan. I was wondering if you got my message on post about sending you the song There's Nothing. Yes, actually. We're going to be hearing that song. I found a copy of it. The song that I was looking for last time, I found a copy of it. I'm so excited. I'm so fucking excited that I found my special copy of my happy song. Take a look at it. Oh, yeah, here's what I think happened. So Boogie made a bunch of money on YouTube, and then he invested like 80% of it in cryptocurrency. And the remaining 20%, instead of paying his house off, he bought himself some chitlet teeth. He bought himself some fake fucking teeth. And then he thought, it's fine. At least I got my teeth on me. And then when that crypto moons, I'll be super rich. And now it didn't, and he's super broke. I love the explanation of the video, too, is just him saying, I listened to my friend. I took my friend's advice. My friend told me to invest in crypto. And then it exploded in my face because I'm fucking fat and stupid. It turned out terribly for me. Oh, so sad. It's so sad, Boogie. What happened? But we can all help Boogie out by ignoring him. I think he said he's fine now. I don't know. I mean, he nearly shot a dude. Fired a bullet in the air. Probably killed a kid half a county over. Let's not get into details. Just I need your help. Help me. Give me money. I did a dumb thing. I went to the roulette table and just put it all on 30. And it all fucked me right up the ass. Oh, Boogie. I think that was the minute. That was our minute. Now, I don't know if any of you like brain busters. If you like puzzles, maybe you like to think through some deep thoughts, chat. I'm not sure. I mean, I know you're all deep thinkers. Deep thinkers wouldn't be able to, or if you weren't deep thinkers, you wouldn't be able to spam nonstop like you did. Round of applause, by the way. Real speed on that. I have to clip that out and send it to Augie and Tom with thanks. But the New York Times runs a real tight ship over there. If you go over to play some of their puzzle games, like Wordly, Wordle, I don't know how you pronounce it. I was actually shocked by just what they'll let you guess is the word, which encourages me to think that one day these will be the words. As you can see, I like to start. I'm going to give you my gym strategy here. So when I start a puzzle, I like to at least try to, you know, you get five letters. You're supposed to guess a word. Now, I want to at least get two vowels in that first word. So I thought, what's a good word with two vowels? And then I want a consonant that's used twice in case it appears twice, because there's some tricky ones they like to hit you with. Yikes, of course. Well, you know, we got a hit. We got an E. So I thought, I need to strategize. I know I've got an E. Let's try it again. Maybe there are two E's in this one. We'll try a few different letters as well. Jude. What do you? I got a J and an E in that one. I'm getting real close, chat. I'm getting real close. So I thought, I got to work my way through the vowels, right? We got I's and E's and all of that. Let's, you know, the sometimes Y. Let's get the O in there. Goyim. Mike's Jude Goyim. Huh. Maybe I need to break it up a little bit. Spice it up. I could have used spice, but I thought spix is a better fit. It's a better fit. That wasn't spix. Didn't get anything on that one. I thought maybe I'm just not trying hard enough. How about Sambo? So at the end of it, Spix, Jude, Goyim, Spix, Sambo. I couldn't figure out the word. I was just lost. Just it wouldn't come to me. You know, that's how every one of my attempts at their puzzle goes. I've tried 300 times now, and I've never gotten it once. But one day, unsuspecting New York Times readers are going to be like, why didn't I guess kikes? Why didn't I put Sambo in as my answer? By the way, that's 100% real. You could go play this stupid game right now, and those are all acceptable. So someday, the New York Times is going to have that as an answer, and it is a good guess. It's a fair guess. There's nothing wrong with trying. You've got to really put some effort into it. I'm seeing, somebody just shot me 1,000 oodles. Over Dodgers. Oh, we got 100 oodles. Oh, everything just got all fucked up, and I lost a message on 100 oodles. Oh, from Joshua Roberts for 25. Thank you for doing a Saturday morning show, champ. Oh, well, I always love to do a morning show. From Unlimited. Bibble, like all his people, used the same washcloth for months to bathe himself because he's a nigger. Yes, Bibble, this is a racial message. I don't think. Guys, I'm starting to think maybe you don't like Bibble so much. Is that a possibility? I don't know. Now, I'm sure you've seen the news. Tragic news, really. Priceless piece of art with an attempt to vandalize it by two very ugly girls. The one on the left, holding a soup can, looks like she probably has Down syndrome, a little Downsy looking. The one on the right looks like the Encino Man. When I first saw this for a second, I thought, holy shit, they're remaking Encino Man. I was kind of excited. I was like, wow, they're going to have like a museum scene. And then they're like, no, that's a woman. That Cro-Magnon looking thing is a woman. That has tits. This isn't even Twitter. Shit, they're just very unfortunate. You know how they say you never should tell somebody they have an ugly baby? This is what that looks like when they've grown up. So Downsy and Encino Man here decide that they're going to do a protest at the museum by throwing soup at something that's it's protected from world-class thieves. It's like temperature moderated behind bulletproof glass. So it does nothing. It accomplishes nothing. But of course, they really wanted to get that message across. Because if you're this ugly, you need to force the world to look at you. So they super glued their hands to the wall. So there they are, with their soup cans. Hideous creatures. Super glued to the wall of this fucking museum. Disappointing the public by making them think there's going to be a remake of a cult classic movie. And of course, there's nothing. Now, there's the actual video of their chanting. Of their chanting and their sisboo rawing. Let me pull that up. Oh, here we go. I love that guy's reaction. You know, there was, I think it was E-Fucked. Used to have, like, really funny porn compilation videos. And there's the casting couch stuff. But there was, like, one... There was one that was, like, a compilation of male porn stars that have really funny-sounding orgasms. And I swear to God, that guy's audio clip belongs in it. Listen to him. It sounds like he ejaculates. It's, like, pure, absolute terror and ejaculation at the same moment when they throw that shit on that painting. Just wait for it. You hear him? You hear that scream? Oh, God. Now they've awkwardly got to grab their glue. You know what would have made this funnier? Because they're both probably retards. If they used, like, just normal glue, Elmer's glue, not like super glue, nothing special, just covered their hands in white glue that easily slides off and doesn't adhere to anything, that would have been comedy genius.
What is worth more?
What is what? England? Come on, England! What is what war?
Art or life? Is it worth more than food?
I have to hear that again. Oh, Downsy. Oh.
What is worth more? Art or life? Is it worth more than food? Worth more than justice? Are you more concerned about the protection of a painting or the protection of our planet and people?
I love how we've got the most governor over here doing her Downsy speech. Look at this one. I'm pretty sure the one on the right eats a fly. Okay? I'm telling you, watch Encino Man as their gecko-like reflexes scan the room for anything flying with wings. And just wait for that tongue to just shoot out and grab lunch.
The cost of living crisis is part of the cost of oil crisis. Fuel is unaffordable to millions of cold, hungry families. They can't even afford to heat a tin of soup.
Oh, all these people are so poor. They can't even, look at this tin of soup that they can't afford that I just threw on the wall and then super glued myself next to. I'm making a statement. It reminds me of that meme picture where it shows the difference between a man taking a picture and a woman. And the man just takes a picture of the object, but the woman has to be right in front of it. And they literally super glued themselves right in front of the painting.
Meanwhile,
crops are failing. Millions of people are dying in monsoons, wildfires, and severe drought. We cannot afford new oil and gas. It is going to take everything we know and love.
That voice. I think that voice caught everybody. What is what? Oh, governor? Oh, governor? Or is it what? Oh. It's just that guttural fucking English.
What is worth more?
Oh. So I saw this video. I saw this just fantastic, amazing video. And I thought, there's... It reminds me of just a pretentious fucking activist. Pretentious activists and art students. And there's one particular video we're going to watch now to really drive that point home. Because these two are exactly the type that would have done this video. I'm talking about Pussy SpaghettiOs. Welcome to Odyssey. Chat, are you excited to watch Pussy SpaghettiOs? I don't know how many of you watched Pussy SpaghettiOs. Stop. Soup Nazis, no soup for you for 1.1 noodle. I love that. Somebody saying no, they don't want to watch Pussy SpaghettiOs, but it's high art. Chat, how can you not appreciate high fucking art? Listen, if this was YouTube, we would have been banned a long time ago with all those names in chat. I think it's time for some Pussy SpaghettiOs. Never heard of it. Oh, Mr. Bacon, you're in for a treat. You're in for a treat. It's not a very long video. It's maybe 5 to 6 minutes long. It's not overly complicated. But it's art. They got a standing ovation for what you're about to watch. Oh, you're in for a treat! Can I just say, I love everything about this video is perfection. I love that they're doing this in a room full of this many people, and they're all just deadly silent. They're all staring in anticipation. What is she going to do with that can of SpaghettiOs? What is this woman going to do with those SpaghettiOs? Except maybe that Asian dude looks a little hungry, like maybe he wants a bite, but he's not going to want to after he sees what she does with it. Just riveted. They're absolutely on the edge of their seat. Just deadly silence. Captured attention. Waiting for the Pussy SpaghettiOs to start. Oh, you know what? Before we even get to the main show, I need to pull chat. I don't know how artistic you guys are. Can you tell me, chat, what amazing statement do you think we're about to watch is in reference to? When I say to you, Pussy SpaghettiOs, what do you think the implied message behind that art is? And yes, she can't get the can open. She's trembling with anticipation. Oil is bad? It's a good guess, Satan. Or Sultan. No sound. Oh, you should be getting sound. If you mean sound from the SpaghettiO video, they're not saying anything yet. No sound on the video. I have it paused. It should be coming through. She's breathing up a storm. She's having a lot of difficulty with her Pussy SpaghettiOs. Mike muted. Okay, then we do have a problem because my mic isn't muted. Uh-oh. Did my stream go to shit? Oh, you're just fucking with me. Okay. All right, you're all just fucking with me. Now, the video's not muted. I'm being dead honest with you. Let me. I'll restart it, chat. I'll restart my Pussy SpaghettiO video. Okay. So you can hear. I've tuned it up. Can you hear the amazing sound of the count or the can crunching? Of the hipsters sitting around staring. Now it has sound. Oh, sound has worked. Praise the gods. Pussy SpaghettiOs is a go. Are you appreciating all this amazing sound quality? God, it's like asking a bitch to open a can of fucking Jiffy peanut butter. She's really having some difficulty here. Maybe change a light bulb for me, honey. This is what happens when a Zoomer is introduced to a can opener. It's like a foreign concept. It's like fucking NASA shit for them. I'm hearing cranking and shit. Chains are being pulled. Your entire art show is SpaghettiOs and you can't even get the can open. Okay, let's pretend it's part of the show. There we go. There we go. Welcome to the Saturday morning stream. We're about to watch a woman do something incredibly interesting with a can of Chef Boyardee. Wow, it's really taken her 2 minutes. Look at this. Maybe this represents the fight against the patriarchy. It's like so hard and junk. Like, oh my god, it requires really tough work and stuff. But Queen here is gonna slay. Listen to her grunt. She's getting fucking horny. Because she knows what's up. I also like how the SpaghettiOs inside the can looks pure black. Because we have to be artistic about it. So I think it's expired. This might be like 3 or 4 year old SpaghettiOs that have liquefied into pure putrid blackness. This might be Odyssey's first exclusive art stream when I think about it. Chat, be sure to say thank you, Julian. Thank you for the art stream.
Dirt is all around us. Everything is shit. We apply meaning, value, and worth to the shit surrounding us. We live by this meaning and by our words.
I'm pausing it for a second. I bet you she wrote this shit down and like she read it in her head and she's like, this is so fucking deep. This is so deep right now. There's so much meaning to what I'm saying right now. It's so deep and it's so meaningful for my Pussy SpaghettiO skit. And now the autism's kicking in, the fear, the terror of being in front of a group when you have something in your head you thought sounded good. But as you're saying it, you're like, holy shit, this is terrible. But I can't stop now. I've got my putrid, rotten SpaghettiOs in the pot and a room full of hipsters. I can't abort now.
We live by worth and applied value, but everything is shit.
I think we just found Acer Thor and his perfect girlfriend. It is true art. Did you check that chick's lookout? Watch as it pans the crowd. Look at the one girl that, like, she gives a side glance to the camera, like, is this shit real? That chick, she's burying her head in laughter. Look at her. Look at her black hair. What the fuck?
Eh.
God, maybe she just left Ethan Ralph's house before doing this art performance and the Rohypnol is kicking in. Maybe that's what it is. Is this Alice the early days? Ah, yes. The symbolism. I want you all to watch my pussy SpaghettiOs. This is up on YouTube, by the way, folks. Before anybody complains, this artistic masterpiece. Up on YouTube. Really, when you think about it, I think it's a statement on climate change. What do you think the smell is? Do you think the smell has hit him by now? I like the chick in the brown leather jacket, because she's just like, fuck me, what is this? You can hear the noise, she's queefing. Oh yeah, take it off. Let's make this abomination of a show even worse. So artistic. I bet she got an A for this. This is like a college assignment. I bet they passed the class. I'm just gonna get the fuck out of here now, because I just squirted out SpaghettiOs from my pussy. Of course, there's the one gay dude in the room screaming encore. What encore would you like to that? What do you think she's going to do as an encore? She just squirted, she queefed out a can of SpaghettiOs and just, I don't know if you saw what that floor looked like. That was in her pussy. She finger fucked herself with rotten Chef Boyardee and then queefed it out in front of you. What encore could you possibly be expecting from this video? How do you follow that up? These two chicks, you know, Encino Man here and Down Syndrome, those two are absolutely the type that would do interior semiotics, I think is the name of the fucking clip. They would go destroy classic art in a museum because they have no appreciation for it. And then they'd go to some college somewhere and watch a chick literally orgasm out rotten SpaghettiOs from her snatch and think that's high fucking art. That's the world we live in. Real art is shit now, and only the most bizarre, retarded interpretation of stupid actions. She gets up there and talks like she's overdosed or has like a brain problem and queefs out SpaghettiOs and gets a standing fucking ovation and people demanding an encore. Welcome to hell. What are you doing, girls? Well, we've got a little bit. Well, we've got a decent amount of some Deep Cover updates. I don't know if you've been following the story of Deep Cover Michael Alberto. Last time, when we checked in on the adventures of Michael Alberto over on Cozy TV, he was telling Nick that he was a fruitcake who needs to kill himself. Basically, told him to shut the fuck up, called him a test tube homunculus whose father's a turkey baster. Very brave and based. Even streaming over there with titles like Nick Fuentes is my bitch, fuck that gay Nick. Now, Michael just doesn't give a fuck. He's playing like Rumper Dumper videos on there. Just doing whatever he wants. So I tuned into one of his early streams. And, you know, he's just chilling there. doing a stream like he normally does. You can see he's top of the pack, king of the hill. All these other people bow down to Michael Deep Cover Alberto. King shit of this dead fruitcake platform. Fuck you, Nick. It's a typical stream title that he goes with. He likes to roll hard when he rolls up in a place. And through a sequence of events, mainly me pitying him playing Minecraft by himself, because god damn was that depressing, and talking about going to the hair salon with his mother, ended up playing some Left 4 Dead 2 with him. And Augie, RFC, and Turkey Tom joined in. We had a little four-player campaign action going on. Now, apparently, you know, Deep Cover, who's been working to infiltrate this organization and take it down from the inside, he crossed a line. All right, he incurred the wrath of the big dogs. I'm talking Nick Fuentes, Ethan Ralph, and of course, Bibble, the guy that shits in toy aisles. So, Michael lit off a fucking firestorm by playing. I want you to understand, it was 4 hours of playing Left 4 Dead 2. That's it. Just playing video games on the internet with other people. And just let's take a look at the reaction. The completely sane and rational reaction to playing a little Left 4 Dead.
So Augie and Turkey Tom, they were on that stream, right?
Yeah, they were.
And they were like, they knew who Metokur is, right? They're openly associated with him.
Yeah.
And did they know he just said like the N-word and F slurs and Twitter slurs and stuff like that like 100 times in his last stream? Were they aware of that?
I'm not sure if they were.
I'm sorry. Is this Cozy TV, home of the kill stream? The top of the sector? F-slurs and Twitter slurs. Or T-slurs. I'm sorry, is Bibble such a little bitch that he can't say fruitcake or Twitter? I didn't know you were so pussy-whipped over there at Cozy TV. I mean, Michael doesn't have a problem saying it. He runs with the big dogs. But Bibble, F-slur. Is the F-slur Bibble's talking about? Is it fruitcake? Is fruitcake the word you're looking for, Bibble? Would fruitcake be the word?
Aware of that, but I think he was doing it today, too, although I didn't hear. But it's from what he said, it sounded like they were doing it today.
Oh, okay. Okay. I'm just curious. I'm just curious if they support that.
Well, they've certainly disavowed for less, I'd say that. I don't know. It does seem to be a weird double standard over there sometimes in the commentary.
Really? Because I thought I could have swore I saw Turkey Tom like trying to dry snitch on Sneeko for associating with Nick Fuentes.
I did see.
I'm pretty sure.
Wow, I don't think I've ever heard a middle-aged white guy pretending to be black use the phrase "dry snitch" like that so uncomfortably. I'm uncomfortable, chat. Are you uncomfortable when you hear an old white man like Bibble? An old white man like Bibble pretending he's a black man saying something like dry snitch. Reminds me of that, you know, how the kids are doing meme. Just doesn't sound natural. Maybe that's why he's not invited anywhere. Or because he says F slurs instead of saying fruitcake. I don't know. I mean, what's the point of being on Cozy if you can't say fruitcake? Maybe that's just the old man mentality Bibble's got going on. I'm not sure.
He made some comments in his fucking video or on Twitter about some shit like that. Yeah,
somebody so on Twitter, get something like that going and tag me in it so I can retweet it, because I don't have time to word the tweet right now. But yeah, that's exactly what he was doing. We pulled that up on air, actually, where he's like, oh, I don't know about associating with Nick Fuentes, yet he associates with Metokur, who, you know, N-word this, N-word that. Yeah, that's true.
I mean, at least 100 times in his last stream, he said it. Honestly, I mean, can we get an answer from Turkey Tom and Augie and maybe, you know, include YouTube in there? I mean, if we're dry snitching, let's play the game.
Is that something we can do? Can we CC in YouTube? Because these guys played a video game? Oh, my God. They played a video game with a guy that another day said the word nigger. YouTube.com. Are you aware that two of your streamers on the 11th of October played Left 4 Dead 2 with somebody that said the word nigger? Are you aware? Bibble, I think you said it 100 times. I think I said it 1,000. I think I said it more than 100 times in the first 5 minutes of this stream. They're actually getting together. I want you to really drink in what these two fucking goofballs are saying. They are so mad that Michael Alberto didn't invite them to play video games, that they want to take down the YouTube channels of Augie and Turkey Tom for playing a video game and not inviting them. Now, I've told the story before, and this is 100% factual, and I'm not making it up. Bibble is a fucking retard, and he's been ass mad for years now because I wouldn't play D&D with him. And just like how he has a death vendetta against me because I wouldn't let him take a deuce on the campaign, he now has declared jihad against Turkey, Tom, and Augie for Left 4 Dead. So basically, if Bibble says, will you play with me? And you say no, Bibble will try to destroy you.
That's how the game is played.
Well, just to get some clarification.
I mean, make sure you include, their YouTube channels.
Now, hold on. Who said that? It was Turkey Tom who said that. It wasn't all you. It was Turkey Tom.
Now, wait a minute. Who was that that said that? So here's little Michael Alberto. Oh, I got an oodle. I know I'm probably missing oodles and donations. I'm trying. Do you think Bibble is one of those black guys who rides a mobility scooter at Walmart when he's perfectly capable of walking from the wall? Yes, I do. Now, wait a second here. Top of the sector can't say the N-word, the T-word, the F-word, the S-word, the J-word, especially not the J-word over here on Cozy, because we love the J's. Laura Loomer, come on. Milo Yiannopoulos, Laura Loomer, my favorite people, come on out here. No J-words over here. Won't say the N-word next to Bibble. He's a white guy pretending to be black. Wouldn't want to upset him. Fucking hell. Oh, another 0.5 oodles. Have some Neo Super Lemons. A lot of oodles coming in now. So Michael Alberto has a video game session. And think about that. You know, Augie has got a stream. You know, he streams fairly regularly. He's got a sizable audience. Turkey Tom has a very large audience. They just showed up to play video games with him. I just showed up to play video. We're all just hanging out playing video games. And there's Bibble and Ralph seething. Just absolutely, anally devastated, fucking furious about this. And Ralph gets invited to come play by Michael. Michael's like, Ralph, do you want to join? Wouldn't do it. Nick Fuentes, you want to come join? Wouldn't do it. They were too scared. In fact, I think Nick Fuentes was so scared, that's why he's in the hospital. He gave himself an ulcer. We'll get to that later. But let's listen to Ralph seethe a little bit more about not getting to play Left 4 Dead with other people and being stuck listening to Bibble ramble on and bore him to tears.
I game with Jim, Tom, and Augie, and now there's a deplatforming effort by Ralph and Bibble to get Tom and Augie banned. No, there's not.
Okay, this is one of the favorite things I love about this fat retard. There literally is. You just heard the clip. I played the clip for everybody here where Bibble and Ralph talk about dry stitching and try to contact CCMN like it's some corporation. We're going to CC in YouTube to get Augie and Tom are going to learn a lesson about playing Left 4 Dead with the inappropriate people. It's not happening. Really? There's not an effort? I mean, we literally just saw the effort.
I game with Jim, Tom, and Augie, and now there's a deplatforming effort by Ralph and Bibble to get Tom and Augie banned. No, there's not.
That's not true. That's not true.
There's a disloyal effort by Michael Alberto. That's what actually happened today. So, no, there's not a deplatforming effort by Bibble, and there's certainly not a deplatforming effort by me. But there was an effort by you to stir the pot here and bring Metokur on into a prime position.
Into a prime position? A prime position where, Ralph? On Cozy Dead Views? Cozy No Views TV? A prime position for what? What prime position? You know, I'm over here on Odyssey right now as an 1100 Andy in a prime position. Because that's generally the best you guys do on a weekday anyway. Or I go on YouTube, that's a prime position. Nobody refers to Cozy as a prime position. Poor Michael Alberto was playing a fucking Minecraft game by himself with like 10 people. It's very sad. So we played some video games together. And then you guys lost your fucking minds over it.
On to Cozy.tv, a site that he's tried to destroy, quite frankly, so... So, no, there wasn't. There wasn't a deep platforming effort, but there was a disloyalty effort for sure. So, that's kind of my thoughts. That's kind of my thoughts on the situation. Of course, everybody can respond how they want, but especially to throw that accusation around at me. I mean, obviously, I'm not gonna. On a day like today, I wouldn't take that. I wouldn't take that sitting down.
You wouldn't take that sitting down? That's all you do. You're morbidly obese, Ralph. I don't think I've seen you stand up. Every time you stand up, somebody hits you in the face. So most of the time we see you, you're sitting down. I wouldn't take that sitting down. No, that's your default position, Peggy.
If you want to know what I really think, I think it was a very disloyal maneuver. And I think it was a bad mistake. That's what I think. But, you know, to each their own. But, yeah, that's my blunt opinion. I think bringing Metokur on like that was a slap in my face. It was a slap in Nick's face. It was kind of a slap to every Prime streamer on here's face. That's
every Prime streamer. Let's go down the list of content, Ralph, for what Cozy TV offers. There's you. What do you offer? Aside from getting hit in the face and pill bottles and drinking. We've got Beardson, who I think is dead. We already went over that. We've got Dalton, who's trying to do like an edgy late night program where he's like a Howard Stern from the 90s that's not working out very well for him. You've got a bunch of other people. Maybe, you know, they pull 50 to 100 views. A lot of video game stuff. Omegle streaming. It's a slap in the face to the quality of Cozy. The quality of Cozy TV over here. So delusional.
That's what I actually think. And that's not a joke, and that's not, there's no punchline, there's no cornball Metokur joke. That's what I actually think. So, you can post that on Telegram too. You can clip that one out. That one's probably a little bit better, I think. But you can post that one up there. But, again, like I said, each person has to make their own decisions and how they want to run things and how they want to do their channel and what they want to say about people who are their superiors and every way, things like that. So we all have to make our own decisions, as I have for many years. But, you know, actions have consequences. That's kind of what they say. So
actions have consequences. Remember, at the start of this fucking clip, he went on about how they weren't leading an effort to deplatform anybody. They're not going after Tom or Augie. You didn't hear that. Bibble, the guy that shits in the toy aisle, didn't tell everybody that they were going to contact YouTube and tattle about playing Left 4 Dead. By the way, while we were playing the game, both Augie and Tom had a mod installed where they took the audio clip of Keemstar saying "nigger" repeatedly, and it overdubbed all the zombies and special effect infected. So that's all they heard the whole game, was Keemstar screaming at the top of his lungs. So I don't think they're super intimidated by the threat of actions having consequences. Maybe this means they're going to pick on Deep Cover, but I don't think he gives a fuck. He seems pretty well situated. He doesn't seem to give much of a shit, Ralph. He's not very scared of you.
You know, saying those things about me, I'm going to say what I think about you, which is that was a really lame, bogus maneuver today, which is what I think. So I wouldn't have said that quite like I did if you hadn't said that lie about me. So here we are. Sal, here we are. That wouldn't have happened if I, you know, haven't seen what you said about me.
Oh, and what did he say about him? Once it came to light that Bibble was threatening to get Augie and Tom in trouble somehow, all Michael Alberto responded was, "That's gay. That's the cardinal sin." He said, "That's gay. It's gay that you would try to do that." And now Ralph is trying to do this Godfather bit. Seething with his sunglasses on and his Mexican tin shed. Trying to scare some 19-year-old Minecraft autist because he played Left 4 Dead with some people on the internet.
But yeah, I think it was pretty bogus, actually. Especially to do it on Cozy. I mean, you could have just went on YouTube or did it anywhere else. I think it was kind of a provocative maneuver done for provocative reasons. I mean, there's just no... I'm not the only one who thinks that either. I've seen a lot of messages, a lot of commentary. I think pretty much everybody thinks that. So, again, I think I'm still being very diplomatic. I'm still being very diplomatic with my language because I generally don't have anything against the guy. But, yeah, I mean, that is what I think. That is my opinion on the matter. So,
holy fuck, is he boring? Oh, I don't know if I could sit through a kill stream. Like, he is just genuinely fucking boring. A lot of them are. It's just boring shit to listen to. Just the monologue. He takes 5 minutes to monologue about being ass mad. You know, after the Michael Alberto thing, he stream sniped 5 hours of Michael Alberto playing Left 4 Dead 2. And then had an hour-long cope session with Nick Fuentes about it. So for 6 hours entirely, he was complaining about Left 4 Dead. Complaining about video games on the internet. And not being invited or not being brave enough to show up. I don't fucking know. And now he's monologuing about it. And it bores me to fucking tears. Bibble is not the only boring fucker on the show. No wonder they're co-hosts with each other. It makes perfect sense.
Like I said, I saw that on Telegram. That's what Jay Yobo was sending me. I didn't see that until just a minute ago. He actually sent that to me earlier. But no, I have no deplatforming efforts against Augie or Turkey Tom. So it's like he just repeats whatever the last thing he heard from Kiwi Farms is, and he's like, "Oh, I'm just asking questions." Like, yeah, okay, yeah, got it. Yeah.
Are you enjoying how much he lies through his fucking teeth? I mean, I put these two clips side by side. They literally talk about deplatforming and Ralph. It never happened. I never tried to deplatform anybody. But you did. You gleefully talked about it with Bibble.
Yeah, just asking questions. Yeah, got it. Well, I'm going to start asking a few questions myself. I'm pretty good at asking questions, actually. That's kind of my specialty, really, is asking questions.
Here's some questions Ralph has asked. He goes to Quora. Is that the question asking for him? Here's the master question asker. Ethan Ralph himself has a Quora account. Is it legal for me to take another person's Xannies? Is that legal to do? If I scratch their name off, does it suddenly become legal to take their prescription medications? That's one of the questions he asked. Another question he asked, not on Quora, he asked the Uber driver this. Hey, could you possibly pick up a woman who's looking very sick and walking down the road? Her drunken buffoon of a son isn't going to pick her up. Could you do that? I'm a master question asker, and I'm just curious. Other master questions that he asks, because he's such a good question asker. Is there a way to possibly not pay child support for my son and still make myself look like the victim? Is that possible? Quora, what is your answer to that? Mystery of the universe here. Is it possible? Is it possible to be a deadbeat piece of shit and somehow make myself the victim and run GoFundMes? Is that possible? Dear Gambian government, Ethan Ralph here. Is it possible that you could find the black Nigerian prince who fucked me out of $200 and fucked my audience out of $200 because I'm stupid and maybe get me the money back? Because that's kind of embarrassing and I haven't talked about it in like 7 months and I was hoping nobody would know. Oh, does he go to Yahoo Answers, Polyfrog? That's a potential. It's a potential he might go to Yahoo Answers to get the answers to these amazing questions that the Question Master asks all the time.
I'm a good question asker. Asking questions. I hope nobody gets offended with me asking a few questions.
Dear Chiffy, I love your chunky peanut butter. Is there another variety of chunky peanut butter that you sell, Chiffy Corporation, that resembles fecal matter? That has the texture, taste, and crunch of fecal matter? Sincerest regards, Master Question Asker, Ethan Ralph.
Anonymous sent $3. Michael Alberto is a queer with a bowl cut.
Just asking a few questions. Let's keep it diplomatic and just ask a few questions. I don't understand. I mean, it doesn't really make sense how getting treated like Medicare's bitch for a few hours and then.
Doesn't make sense, Ralph. Speak from personal experience. I treated you like a bitch for 2.5 hours on Monday match stream, and you sat there with a smile till you started crying and ran away. Oh, Michael Alberto was treated like a bitch. No, I played video games with him. But somebody that did get treated like a bitch would be you. Now, as a master question asker, maybe you could bring that up on Yahoo Answers or Quora. Dear Quora, how do I live down the shame of running away from Mundane Matt on a stream when he cornered me? Dear Yahoo, master question asker Ethan Ralph here. Is there possibly a way that I could make the internet forget that I cried in front of a live stream audience? Is that possible? Can I accomplish that?
And, like, pissing off everybody who actually watches any of your streams. I don't know. I guess he does have some Kiwi crossover or something, but I don't know. It doesn't really make sense to me. Like, I guess he does have some crossover from some of them, but it doesn't really make sense from an audience building strategy either.
It's like he ran out of energy. Like, he just started to crash into slumber midway through whatever the fuck he was just. He ran out of steam. Somebody needs to ring Pantsu downstairs and have her bring up a hot burrito cooked on their tin roof because they can't have fire or gas at that place because the adobe walls made of shit will melt in the Mexican rural countryside they're residing in. Now, this wasn't the end for Michael. Was it just Bibble and Ralph and Nick seething? Oh, everybody was getting mad. A guy literally calls himself Cancel Proof. I've supported Michael Alberto since I got to know him. Michael, you can't make everyone your friend. At times, you have to pick a person or a group, or else pick neither. I've unfollowed his channel and withdrawn my support until he starts making or acting with more integrity. Come on, Mike! It occurs to me that he's openly hostile to people who you consider your friends, and you don't even appear to defend them against lies and, and calumny. Alberto Mod, known Kiwi Farm people, and people who dox or attempting to dox Cozy streamers on his Cozy channel. Not high integrity move and only gives AF enemies more drama fodder. I should, by the way, deep cover Michael Alberto modded Kinoche. And if you know anything, Ralph hates Kinoche. So he gets modded over there by Mike, I don't give a fuck Alberto. And now Paul from Cancel Proof wants him canceled. Oh, but the Goipers, the Catboys, they were a-hissin'. Kinoche is a mod too, Lamau. And Ratberto's chat. Michael is well beyond having the benefit of the doubt. It's just straight up malicious. The only community that would accept him. He's a fruitcake, plain and simple. Enjoy the A-logs ruining your life, dumb retard. It's called We Facilitate a Little Bit of Slander and Biting the Hand That Fed Me. Called it months ago. Alberto is compromised. This is coming from a group of retarded fucks, the stupidest fruitcakes on planet Earth, that has Baked Alaska, Baked I Signed Up With The Feds Alaska, Baked, oh look at the mysterious 7 Groypers that just got arrested Alaska, on their fucking platform. But Michael Alberto is compromised, because he played a little Left 4 Dead too. He is a fruitcake and a traitor. His channel should be removed from Cozy post-haste. And he should be stomped to death like Matthew Shepard in Minecraft. Why aren't you being a little more direct? What do you mean in Minecraft? A little bit of a pussy there, Dixie Respector? Come on, Southern boy. Take the Minecraft out. Show me you got some balls, you pussy little bitch. Alberto, top mod, by the way. Thanks for including me in your screen cap. And a little bit more here. No one cares about your fence-sitting fruitcake tree. Just go be with your Kiwi fruitcake friends. Oh, literally? Like, actually? Really? Modded Kinoche, by the way. They really don't like Kinoche very much, if I had to be honest with you. Oh. Oh, got a few more donations. Let me run to the money from Red Pill Gaming. I'm starting to think you playing with Michael 14 Words Alberto is what sent Nick to the hospital. We will get to that. his tragic story in the hospital. It's unreal. It's like a little group of high school girls. It's Mean Girls. It's Mean Girls. That's what Cozy TV is. Of course it's like that, because it's run by a gay dude. Of course it's turned into Mean Girls. Telegram chats, Twitter chat, multiple streams, because Michael Alberto, instead of playing Minecraft by himself to an audience of no one, hung out with me, Turkey Tom, and Augie, and played a little Left 4 Dead 2. And it was a complete fucking meltdown. You know, Kinoche, not only is he in Deep Cover's, you know, channel as a mod, he also had breaking news, breaking Nick Fuentes news, pinging everybody in the middle of the night, but it appears that Nick Fuentes has shit his pants and was rushed to the hospital. Please pray for him. Breaking news. Nick Fuentes experienced fecal incontinence for the first time and shit his pants after eating McDonald's last night and had to cancel his show. He was rushed to the emergency room. And that is actually from Nick Fuentes' telegram. He had to go to the hospital. Now, a lot of people are asking, what happened to Nick? What happened to Nick? Well, I think he finally decided to live his best life. But just like when you shouldn't go grocery shopping when you're hungry because your eyes are bigger than your stomach. Well, Nick, being that Kanye fan, loving black culture, his eyes were a little bit bigger than his asshole. And he got a little bit of a rumper dumper injury. Had to get rushed into the hospital immediately. But this is a good moment, folks. We've been waiting for this, because that means Nick is finally living his best life. He's finally stepping out of the closet. No more creep shots of his interns. No more pretending that he doesn't absolutely love Euphoria and tape it every night, because he does. And we need to celebrate. We need to celebrate. I'm going to call this Rumper Dumper Liberation Day. Mark it on your calendars. October 15th is Rumper Dumper Liberation Day. Nick Fuentes has finally stepped out of the closet. Let's celebrate it with a little bit of music, a song dedicated. Dedicated to a man who's finally ready to live a proud out life. This one's for you, Nick.
There's nothing wrong with being a fan. If you want to take it up the ass, then that's okay. There's nothing wrong with being a fucking faggot.
That man just come out the closet?
Cause as long as you say no homo, it's not gay. I said it's not gay. If the balls don't touch it, if they that's okay. Cause there's nothing wrong with being a fucking faggot.
Little bitch.
There's nothing wrong with being a faggot.
Fucking faggot.
If you wanna take it up the ass, that's fine with me. There's nothing wrong with being a dick-sucking, fudge-packing fat. Cause as long as you say no homo, it's not gay.
Oh, really? Oh, really tugs at the heartstrings. Really, really gets me down deep, guys. I'm feeling it. The cackles of my heart, I'm feeling it. Nick, you could finally like go to glory holes and not dress like this. You could finally go and suck dick proudly at the gas station or the bus stop or the truck stop without having to hide your identity anymore. It's a liberating day. It's Rumper Dumper Liberation Day. And your aunt is going to be so happy to get her doily back that you used as a makeshift do-rag that you stole off some old woman's coffee table and dyed black so you look like a hip-hop star. With your trash bag. Nick, you don't have to creep in the shadows anymore to get your fix of cock anymore. It's going to be, it's Rumper Dumper Liberation Day, Nick. Are we so happy? It's his gimp suit, somebody in chat said. Potentially. Potentially it is his gimp suit. Might be what's going on here. I don't know. Ah, these cozy fuckers, man. These cozy fuckers. We have more cozy stuff, and then the Walmart stuff, too. I'm very excited about the Walmart stuff. I'm so excited about the Walmart stuff. But we've been going for an hour. I'm going to grab a drink. Let me put a little music on. Ooh, what song should we listen to as our break song this time? Maybe a little bit more Moon Man? Oh, I think maybe. I wasn't thinking of like break music. Like what break music could we use? Let's see. Oh, somebody started uploading a lot of... There's suddenly a lot of Moon Man shit up on BitChute. I'm not saying... I don't know why, but all of a sudden, there's a fuck ton of new songs that are being uploaded in mass on BitChute right now under hashtag Moon Man. There's entire albums being fucking uploaded right now. I don't even know what to pick. I don't even know what to pick. Let's see what this one is. Some of these I haven't even heard of. I don't know if they're any good or not.
The haters on YouTube are on the verge of flooding with hate comments.
Cause you got that. Cause you got that.
Must wake up.
Cause you got that.
Must fight back.
I heard the lips on the lips.
But this is exactly the pattern.
It depends on the child, really, doesn't it? Most well-known and credentialed scientists of this YouTube community.
Yeah. Oh, you moron.
All I wanted to do was live this fucking stream and have a good time. Maybe have a good game.
You got that.
That damn Kiwi Farms. Gas.
You got that.
I don't know how to use words that well.
My dad is not a fucking dwarf.
Dude, you just talk to my fucking giant.
I got balls of steel.
Oh my god, no!
Blow it out your ass.
From our little break with our family-friendly song by Moon Man. God, it's been forever. I remember when there was nothing but Moon Man on YouTube. Just the edgiest shit. You couldn't ever play it. Oh, there we are, though. Hopefully you grabbed a drink. We'll bang out the rest of this. Let me see here. Chat, it's time to do an audio check. All right, I want to make sure, I'm running a high-quality stream here. It's important. It's audio check time, chat. I hope you're ready. So let's just bear with me. Should just take a second. called in an expert to help me with this.
Dinner. I didn't dox him. That's not true. That's not true. As a matter of fact, no, that's not true. No, it's not true. Fuck yourself, you piece of shit. Motherfucker! No, it's not true! Piece of shit! If I had to guess, it was probably you that fucking doxed him! Motherfucking lying, cocksucking motherfucker! You want to holler over me every fucking second? Or did you scream over you too, you piece of shit, motherfucker? Keep fucking running your mouth! I'll just keep hollering, you motherfucking piece of shit! Eat a fucking cock! Go kill yourself, you fucking piece of motherfucking shit! I fucking goddamn! Oh, we can just holler over each other all fucking day! Oh,
I think we're good. I think the audio is good. I think we're sitting pretty. Now, a week couldn't go by if Ralph and cohorts weren't trying to start a war with Odyssey. I don't know why. It's a lovely little platform over here. Love it. Thank you so much, Moloch, for getting back to me on my email account. And I've never sacrificed goats, but I'll look into it if their blood will give me demonic power. But, of course, it's a day of the week, so here goes Ralph, starting a war with fucking Odyssey. Now, Ralph was, angry because Julian had said, turns out J.P. Morgan dropped Kanye's decline a month ago, and it had nothing to do with his tweet. Kanye discussed difficulties with the bank during an interview, and J.P. Morgan decided to cut ties. To which Ralph responds, you and Odyssey have a history of dishonest behavior. Kanye and Candace Owen never lied about me or enforced their policies unfairly in favor of others, as you and your company have done. I'll definitely take ye and Candace over you fraudsters. The response? Kanye and Candace don't know you, Ethan. What the fuck are you even talking about? No, she hasn't. Candace doesn't know what Ralph is. I like how he says what Ralph is. See, that's a Freudian slip, but it's a very relevant one. It's not who Ralph is. It's what he is. Only somebody who's seen that this man possesses four tits and two stomachs would have a sentence like that. What is he? That's a maybe question master Ethan Ralph can ask Quora about that. What is he exactly? What they don't know is you, who you are, but I'm getting ready to show him if you keep fucking with me. Yeah, she has lying, bitch. I've known Candace since 2016. It was the first interview her out of everybody around here. Congrats, but she pretends she doesn't know you now. And of course, here we go. Wrong. Unlike you and Odyssey, Candace is 100%. I wonder if all the brothel workers in China that you told me you frequently pay sex for remember you, or the porn stars you creepily obsess over. You just guaranteed that I'm dumping all that, Julian. You should be smarter. Now, if you remember... Ethan dumped a bunch of emails and made massive threats about burning Odyssey to the ground and teaching Julian a lesson. And if you go look for these tweets, they're nowhere to be found. But you'll see people replying to him with a bunch of deleted by authors. So once again, Ethan Ralph has run his big, stupid, fat fucking mouth and run away with his tail between his legs. Well, maybe not run. Maybe waddled is a better choice of terms. And of course, Nick has to join in too. Is this the CEO of Odyssey sipping for J.P. Morgan and the Daily Beast? Devil worshiper, by the way. Hurtful. Just hurtful. Now, I'm not sure if you're all aware of this, and I didn't clip this out because it would force me to listen to more Ethan Ralph, and I'm just not willing to do that. But during his cope session after the Left 4 Dead game, when Ethan and Nick were hugging each other and shivering together because people were playing Left 4 Dead, Nick let it slip that he has people keep track of my post account and count up what I say and how much I say it, because I live in his head. I live in Nick Fuentes' head, and I can make him do whatever I want. For 2 weeks, I've been making jokes about him vomiting at McDonald's. For 2 weeks, I've been making jokes about him punching the walls and because of getting angry in Discord. For 2 weeks, I've been talking about how great Odyssey is. So let's watch the response. And see if it's fucked with his head a little bit.
Now I feel awesome. Now I'm making phone calls, I'm texting people, feeling positive, laughing at cozy content. And it dawned on me, I've got low blood sugar. That's my problem. I always had that, you know, hypoglycemic. I was almost diagnosed pre-diabetic when I was a kid. I'm genetically predisposed to type 2 diabetes. And I was almost diagnosed. I just stopped going to the doctor because I didn't, you know, I was just didn't want to hear the, I didn't want to hear any more of that. So I've always just been out of sorts. I don't eat. I think I told you this. I've been out of sorts when I don't eat. So I Googled it. I said, what do you do? What can you take for that? That's not drugs. And they said chromium. Chromium helps regulate blood sugar. So I started taking that. I don't know if it's that, but lately I just feel so much more regulated. I feel more on top of it. I feel stable.
You hear that, folks? He's not vomiting up his McDonald's anymore. For months, Nick Fuentes kept talking repeatedly about how every time he'd eat McDonald's, he'd end up on the bathroom floor, vomiting up his Happy Meal. And you start making jokes about it and getting ass-fucked by Ronald. And all of a sudden, this motherfucker's out there sucking chrome off pipes. I don't know where he's getting his chromium from. He's just eating all the chromium he can get his hands on.
And it's got me wanting to try more. I want more supplements. I want more. I was taking a multivitamin. It smelled like shit. You ever get a nice...
Well, to be fair, he borrowed that from Ethan Ralph, so it might not have been the multivitamin.
Did it cause me to burp? That's a little too much. But I think if I just get the right mix, I'm thinking maybe low-dose lithium.
Okay, let's pause for a second. Let's pause for a second. There's a bit of a difference between somebody saying, yeah, you know, I want to take a multivitamin, get a little vitamin C in my diet, and then transitioning from, you know, some vitamin B, some vitamin D, some lithium. I maybe need large doses of lithium to control my rage issues, to go along with my chromium. I like how he just slipped it in there.
Is what Heiding recommended to me, the assistant Groiper, and I don't know, recommend, what are your favorite supplements? Because I started taking the chromium, I noticed a real difference.
I'm not vomiting anymore. And all the people that work around me keep telling me, Nick, you need to take lithium. Maybe he really thinks lithium is like a dietary supplement. He doesn't understand like the context behind that. So when all his assistant, he's telling people that it's people in his organization, people that work for Nick keep telling him he needs to take his bipolar ass, his rage disorder having ass. Needs lithium. You need lithium, Nick. Trust me. We all got together. We made a list of what Nick needs. Top of the list, cock. Second on that list, lithium.
Real change. Maybe that's just in my head. I don't know. But anyway.
But anyway, all the people that know me keep telling me I need to be on high doses of lithium. You know, the supplement. Supplemental lithium. Just everyday average supplemental lithium. Okay, Nick. Okay. Chat, maybe HRT I see in chat. That's a potential. It's a possibility. Will he start selling gay vitality pills? Possibly. Chat, possibly. Oh, should we try to get him to eat batteries? I bet I could convince his stupid ass to eat batteries. That shouldn't be too difficult. Bathtub lithium. Maybe Keffels will show him how to make, you know, it's like a component of Twitter shine. He can, like, siphon it out. Chewable lithium. Chromium is poison. It causes cancer and heavy metal poisoning. Is that why he's in the... Could you imagine? He's that stupid. That's the reason Nick Fuentes is in the hospital right now. Is because he's been downing bottles of chromium. And he has heavy metal poisoning? He can't possibly be that dumb. He's got bathtub lithium, and he's eating fucking chromium like it's protein powder. He's mixing it like a shake, like you would at the gym. Oh, is that the Sunny Day? Is that the name of it? His special recipe? It's called Fruit Shine? Yeah, I'm trying to think, like, do you think Nick wakes up in the morning covered in vomit and then he makes a big old chromium lithium protein shake and just drinks it all down? What a world. Oh, we got an Oodle donation. I'm sorry, a Beelzebuck donation. Nick took lithium batteries on his laptop as a suppository. It's a possibility. We don't know. We're not doctors. Chat, we're not doctors. We don't know exactly what he's done. Oh, my God. You know, so that's our cozy content. Moving on from that. Oh, also, once again, rip to Beardson. You'll be missed. So moving on from that, I am obsessed with watching Ouija videos and ritualistic humiliation. That's why this is titled Welcome to Walmart. But it's hard to find a good compilation of just the pure human suffering that people are made to endure when they work at Walmart. A lot of people think that that McDonald's is the worst place on earth. But I think, you know, I want to introduce you to this. So I put together a little sizzle reel of what a living hell looks like if you work at Walmart. And this is, I think, pretty accurate to describe what a living hell would be to walk into every day. So welcome to Walmart. This is my Walmart montage. Let's kick it off with a video Walmart prepared to really get their employees in the mindset they're going to need to do their little Ouija shuffle every day.
Walmart means to me everything right now. Being able to
Get me a rhythm!
Dance for me, Ouija! Dance!
Follow me!
It's every one of these videos, it hurts my soul. Every time I watch a Ouija dance video, it's pure humiliation ritual. There's no other explanation for it. There's no reason to do this to your employees unless you fucking hate them. And when you look at the pay disparity between a manager who makes over 100K a year, that is always going to be the one cheerfully dancing in the middle, and all the other part-time employees making a nickel an hour, and they just look like they want to die. They just want to fucking go to the aisle with the cleaning supplies and laundry detergent and drink the fucking bleach. They hope that opening happens to them.
We are Walmart. Two more times. We are Walmart. We are Walmart.
Somebody in chat asking, is this legit in the USA? Yes, it is. This is absolutely 100% something that happens. This is a team-building exercise. This is the living hell that you endure if you work at a Walmart. It's not bad enough you get shit hours, part-time, no medical benefits, nothing. No protections, you can be fired on the spot. No unionization, nothing. They make you dance for their amusement. You will literally do a Ouija shuffle for them, and you'll fucking like it.
Oh,
so filled with rage. He's so fucking filled. He's curled up into a fetal position. Even the manager's had enough. It's just nothing but screaming. I think he started with that. I think he started his chant with, "Give me a fucking W." And then he curls up in a fetal position on the floor, and I think he's just going to have explosive shit right onto their khaki pants. That's right, Wagey. I'm your fucking boss. I'm wearing black pants. Nobody will tell. I'm going to shit all over you, and you're going to clean it up with a mop, and you're going to fucking like it. Now give me a fucking W.
What was that? Oh, that's good. You guys must be watching Family Guy.
Isn't this, chat, isn't this what you want to do? I want you to imagine, it's Tuesday. It's like 5:30 in the morning, and you just showed up for your shift, and your boss said you need to be there early so you can work off the clock, because I'm sure they do that. And you walk out onto the floor, and you're like, oh, fuck. And every single staff member's there. And the guy that lives in a mansion with his $120,000 salary a year, who's going to replace you with a robot, he's got a big fucking smile on his face because he watched Family Guy and he heard the best song ever. And now, off the clock, not getting paid, he's going to make you shake your ass. And all you want to do, you want a sip of coffee. Just one sip, just one tiny sip of coffee before you put a bullet in your head. But nope, it's time to learn that the bird is the one. Now, chat, take a guess. You saw the other manager who was screaming fuck and then got in a fetal position and shit on people. Do you think this manager is going to roid rage at the end of this? I don't think there's a poll feature. I don't know if there's a poll feature, chat. So I'm just going to ask you. Give me a 1 if you think at the end of this clip he's going to roid rage out on these people. Give me a 2 if you think he's going to just break down into tears. Because one of those two things is going to happen. So are we going to get roid rage? Or just sobbing uncontrollably? Which is it going to be? Which are we going to get? Remember, he's a manager, not an employee. Seeing a lot of ones. Seeing a lot of ones. Let's see where it goes. Let's see if chat's right. Ready to fucking kill you, AG. He legitimately roid rages out there. He legit roid rages. You see, look at the guy's like, give me a fist bump. He wants to rip his fucking throat out. The manager has smelled blood. He's ready to sacrifice. He's going to kill somebody. Just start screaming and raging the fuck out. It's great.
Oh, they make them dance for security. That's right, Weiji. Get in front of the camera and dance.
Walmart has reached a point. They've become scientific about this. It's not just we want to humiliate you. We don't want to just make you do the bird is the word dance or the hokey pokey anymore. We're going to pay musical groups to rewrite songs with new lyrics and then make you dance to the Walmart version of those songs. They've literally made a Wagey Shuffle song specifically for Walmart and set up security cameras. And they have to, for people not in the United States, let me let you in on this. You are legally required to dance twice during your shift. When the music starts, you need to get in front of a camera and immediately start doing the Walmart shuffle or you're fired on the spot. People are doubting me. I'll tell you what, chat. Here's my challenge to you. There are phones that are in Walmart that you can pick up that will page the store. Record the song Walmart Shuffle, and then go in at any time during the day and play it on that phone. And you will see employees running from every single fucking department in the store and immediately start doing dance moves like a flash mob in front of the nearest security camera. I'm telling the truth. I know Europeans probably don't think this is true. When you visit America next time, try it. I love how it's just so low energy. Nobody wants to do this shit. Nobody wants this team building bullshit that some fucking retard in HR with some, let's say, $100,000 degree from some semi-prestigious university came up with for team building exercises. Nobody wants to do this. Nobody wants to walk into work at 6 in the morning and have their fucking boss want to do yoga, dance-offs, shuffles, the bird is the word, but they just keep doing it to them.
Alright, man. Alright. Yeah.
Ready?
Okay, jump. Ready?
This is all for minimum wage. Oh my God, there's going to be like a class revolution one day in the United States, and it's just going to be nothing but Walmart workers. That's who's going to lead it. Just dance for me, jump for me, do some yoga for me, put a smile on your face, clean my shit up. Hey, that crazy person over there defecated in the toy aisle right next to the DM manual. Clean it up. Just non-stop humiliation rituals.
W-L-A-A-R-T. Squat! Okay, jump again. Come on, baby. Come on, give it up. Come on.
You were gonna fucking high-five me, and you're gonna like it. You're gonna like it. You don't get a choice in this. Give me five, Wagey. Slap my fucking hand. Don't slap it too hard, I'll fire your ass. Now dance for me. Jump and jiggle for me, Wagey. Jump and jiggle for me. Somebody in chat, how tasty is a bullet right now? Delicious. Absolutely, absolutely delicious. Oh, from Ted Box from Pit Viper. Just wanted to send a shout out to my buddy Adelwolf. Proud of you for finally be out and proud about being both Ethan Ralph's biggest and thirstiest Janny. and PayPig, as well as the biggest fur fruit gone cozy. Well, can we get a round of applause for Ito Wolf for being the biggest fur fruit gone cozy? I got a dollar coming in, too, from Do You Think They Have to Dance at the Edge of the Roof Before Doing a Flip? From Necro Familiar. I don't know. Now, that's like a Chinese riddle, really. If the Weiji kills himself by following orders from his boss, the Weiji can't clean the mess up. How do you solve that? That's like a what's the answer? You're like a sphinx here. There's got to be a secret to it. If you do a flip off the rooftop, you've made a mess you need to clean up. Will your boss resurrect you to make you clean it up? I'm not sure exactly how that works. I think if you've tricked me, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to answer that. Oh, from Anton. Next Cozy Gaming Stream, you need to bring RPG and Jaden. I'm sure Nikki would love that. He is a gay fruitcake. Well, that is true. You know, we should get Jaden and RPG and Michael and me to play some Left 4 Dead on Cozy. I think that would be a fantastic idea. Maybe we could do it to celebrate Rumper Dumper Liberation Day. That's always a possibility. Did you call it a prime tartadox? Oh, no, a prime pterodox. I'd call it a prime tartadox. The next Weiji cleans it up. The machine that replaces a Weiji cleans it up. For 0.39 oodles. Have you watched Cyberpunk Edgerunner, and who is the best girl? No, I haven't watched it yet. I haven't gotten a chance to watch it yet. Boomer Metokur fans can't figure out Odyssey. Oh, that's a possibility. We're sitting here comfortably as a 1300 Andy. We're less of an Andy than last time. It's probably because the 100 Walmart workers that watch the stream have already done a flip off the rooftop. I'm sorry, rip in peace. This one's for them. Oh my God, $5 from Michael Alberto, deep cover himself. Nick needs to make Ralph Baked and Beardson do the cozy shuffle. Is that what they're calling it now? At their half-naked tickle fights? Is it called the cozy shuffle? Michael Alberto, who is totally Michael Alberto? Watch it, Jim. It's really good. You talk about Edgerunner? I don't know. Maybe it is good. But I haven't had a chance to watch it yet. Listen, I'm still getting over the heartbreak that is the shittiest video game that's ever been made, Scorn. I love it when a game goes out on Kickstarter or some fundraising platform and is in development for 8 years, and the shit that they show 8 years ago is almost the entirety of the game itself. I love games that are 2 hours long. I love games that make you think they're a survival horror shooter with a dark aesthetic and an interesting world, and it turns out to be a reskinned version of Myst with shittier puzzles. I like that. That's what I want. Having no story, lore, background, or character, that's important to me. Having an ending that makes me want to punch the screen, that's important to me. Putting boss fights in that just drag the time limit just over 2 hours so you can't get a Steam refund, also important to me. These are all high points, boxes that have been checked by the wonderful development team at Scorn. Oh, was it 10 years? Of course. Why not? 10 years. Sure. 8 years, 10 years. It's 2 hours of disappointment once you get there. Who knew that Left 4 Dead 2 could cause so much spurging? Mr. Bacon. Well, it can apparently cause quite a bit of spurging. The title is what the devs feel for you? Very true. It's very true. That is what they scorn and derision. Is what they feel for you. How they fucked that game up so bad, I will never know. I don't fucking understand it. It had so much potential, it looked so good. You got close to a decade to fuck around with it. Finally comes out, and it's like they just didn't give a shit. What a disappointment. What a massive disappointment of a game. You know, I was already upset with Hellraiser. Like, the remake was meh, right? So, The remake, remaster, re-envisioning of the new Hellraiser that came out on Hulu back on, the 7th? It was a meh movie. It wasn't terrible, but it sure wasn't great either. And I was like, okay, that's disappointing. But at least Scorn is going to come out, and it's going to be good. It's going to be dark and edgy and all that shit. All Geiger-esque. And it's so bad. It really is reskinned Myst with shittier puzzles. It is a two-hour walking experience. Somebody said, no, I only watched 1 hour. Don't spoil it for me. I won't spoil the killer ending. Okay, where all you get all the answers you want. I'm not going to spoil that for you. That would be a dick move. What is this? DSP? Oh, hold on a second. DSP was used in a case study on some Sony conference. You literally called it in a Brightside Bob video years ago. And you're linking to something. Let's take a look at what this is. Is this actually real? Okay. No, I think I know what you're talking about. This was like a presentation at one of the developer conferences. Sounds about right. Sounds about right. I don't know about the Roku app. Digital Void. I haven't tried using the Roku app on this. A Fed post McGee is threatening to put Michael Alberto's head in a jar. Very scary. Truly terrifying. Truly terrifying moment. You know, I was going to look at the DSP thing. It was interesting. Maybe we should do a little bit more of a deep dive and take, I don't know. Should we look at a little more Moon Crickets, chat? Now, not their 48-minute long song. That's too much Moon Crickets. But just a little bit more Moon Crickets. A little bit more of the Moon Cricket mentality. But I don't know. Do we want to watch an interview video with the Moon Crickets to find out the genius behind it? Or do we want to watch a Moon Cricket music video where they dress up as Guy Fawkes and pretend they're anonymous? Are we going to watch the black Kemet community rap group dress up as Guy Fawkes? Is that the Moon Cricket madness that we want? Moon Crickets rise up. Well, I don't know. Okay, all I see is Guy Fawkes holding a liquor bottle. Let me get this set up. I don't know. I mean, it is Moon Cricket, so it can't be bad. It's got to be absolutely 100% amazing. There we go. Let's take a look. Oh.
Serial killers, our priests bring the game back to life at will. Kill a game again, deceased. Whisper mysteries of the dawn. Many levels that I walk on are still long. Bandana mask long when I walk. I'll rape monuments strong. Vision my thoughts are made of metal. It draws a sea face of dawns. Kings and pawns reborn as rebel. Silver form born in golden dawns. While they see the pebbles they cast. Wrath is born beyond. Hold straight up, offending with the thoughts. While they see him gone, offending. Thoughts seared where there's no defenses.
Fuck Babylon.
A take over senses, God type. Kid whores brought by the storm. They smoke the bomb, chow while five in the morn. Whirly rest my head in the dawn. Hymns torn, apocalypse switching the song. Ill war is gone wrong.
Why Guy Fawkes? Why the Guy Fawkes mask? It's the one thing that doesn't. I mean, I know these motherfuckers are rapping about like the Genophage and Mass Effect and fucking Mech Warrior and everything else if you watch their animated video. But like, the Guy Fawkes shit, I don't understand it. I guess I don't get it.
While the stick's still shifting, on a level we get on renditions of the system. Blaze out while he still walk. Visualism is still keep crying out. Nod with no hearts, the mind shit. Into the thoughts, we utilize that. Ill would see it, ill the reflection, the flashback.
Elevation time, elevate your mind. Levitate, it's the great fate. A combined mentality, one casualty in mind. Effortlessly express the sublime expressions of time. Elevation time.
Nope, you know what? I'm making an executive decision here. I'm sorry, but this is not the hotness. This is unacceptable. I blame Guy Fawkes. How do you go from Rapocalypse, which was just the best shit that was ever been made on the internet, to this? This is not good. First, there's that chick rapping in there. All right, not very good. I'm not feeling that flow. But the thing that really upsets me is Guy Fawkes out there contributing fucking nothing. I'm sorry. This is just, it's unacceptable. I pulled the plug on the Moon Crickets. I want to leave them with a positive memory. I don't want to leave with a memory of a shit song. I thought, oh, Guy Fox, Moon Crickets, match made in heaven. That's going to be great. No. Sadly, no. I need to wash the taste of this out of my mouth by watching autistic people beat things. Let's see. Just a basic search. Autistic rage. Here's a classic one from 10 years ago that's still somehow up. Let's watch Mommy's Special Boy punch fucking holes in the wall. Holy shit, I can't believe it's still up. Okay, let me get the audio settings. There we go. Here we are.
This is where he's put his head through the wall, and this is where he stood and kicked it.
Hey, fun fact, this is actually Edelwolf. This is Ethan Ralph's top moderator. You didn't know it. I know, oh my god, I'm dying people. But this is him.
He's 6'2" and he weighs 252 pounds. He can go through this house and just wipe everything out probably in 10 minutes. You know, I've had him turn furniture over. You see all the windows and stuff. You know, the air conditioner back in the bedroom, he'll sit and punch that till it's in pieces. You know, in other words, if it breaks anymore, it's kind of like, it's material, it can be replaced. I don't even let it bother me, but the destruction is...
Look at the holes underneath the air conditioner. You know, I've seen this clip before, but sometimes I never really paid attention to it. I got lost in the shit she was saying. How did he even do that? He's taken out, like, a whole fucking section of the drywall. That air conditioner is going to fall off that fucking window ledge. There's no support underneath it. You can see, he didn't just punch the fucking walls, he ripped the insulation out, too. Oh, man. I guess when you make fun of Edelwolf, he really can't handle it. He's causing a lot of damage for Mommy here.
Just unbelievable. What are you so mad about?
I have to go. Why those?
What are you so mad about?
The Miser Brothers.
Calm down.
Let me translate. Edelwolf here is saying, the reason that he's so mad is that those dastardly Kiwi farmers keep making fun of him for wanting to fuck Twitter.
Look, you got Santa Claus is coming to town.
Of all the fool things for them to do.
You got Santa Claus is coming to town.
Ow!
Don't do that. Owie! Owie! He's part of the family, and you hate to give up on your child as a lost cause. But I've come to the conclusion now that the best thing would be to place him somewhere where they can control him and they're not going to hurt him. I'm afraid, though, if I do leave him at home, it'll be like that man that they took to one of the...
Chat, how long would it take you to just... How long would it take you, like that Walmart employee we were talking about earlier, just to front flip right off the building? Like, every day. Every day you wake up, and he's in there doing the thing in the background. How long until you're like, you know what? It's time to stop. I can't live with this anymore. He keeps eating the insulation. Edelwolf, stop hitting the walls. I don't know who Ethan Ralph is. Edelwolf, what the fuck is the kill stream? Edelwolf, calm down.
There's, or centers last weekend that got out of control and they tased him and he died of a heart attack. Yeah, you understand what's going through my head, why I'm not opposed to taking him and placing him somewhere, because this can't go on and other people cannot control him like me.
If you ask me, still in serious trouble.
What's the problem, officer?
What's the problem? I'll tell you what the problem is.
driving.
Oh, owie.
What do you call that thing anyway?
You watch your movie?
Somebody should take this clip. Somebody should take this clip and retitle it, re-upload it with the title Living with Edelwolf and see how long it takes them to figure. Just throw it out there. Don't tell anybody you've done it. Don't tell anybody you've done it. Just re-upload the clip, title it Living with Edelwolf, and just see how long it takes them to find it. Like, do you think it would be months or weeks? How long would it take? How long would it take Edelwolf to find that clip? With his fucking name on it. His fucking username. Oh, that's better. See, that's better. That was better than the Guy Fox thing. That's an oldie but a goodie. Oh, Point One Uno, sell him to the mariachi band. Well, he'd fit right in. A lot of guesses, 33 seconds, 4 hours. 12 seconds, do you think he would get to it right away? There is such a thing as too much empathy. This is Acer Thorn as a child? Potentially. Potentially, Chad. Put him in a wood chipper. You guys are being awfully mean. This is a nice place. We get together and we do good things here. Saying such mean, hurtful things. Somebody in chat, he has Google notifications turned on. Does he really? So if I did like the next morning with Metokur and I titled it, I don't know, Edelwolf Eats Shit Live on Camera, would he be like the first person waiting? If I called it Mornings with Metokur, Edelwolf fist fucks a pony, would he be the first person? Would that instantly ping his fucking phone and Google alerts would send him running? Like, what title should we use it for the next Mornings with Metokur to get Edelwolf here immediately? Edelwolf, big reveal. Obese man lactates on camera to the laughter of children. Like, what title would pull him in? Summon him like some satanic ritual. I guarantee it. Yes, do it. The horse fisting one? Edelwolf secret video. Edelwolf reviews fur affinity. Edelwolf takes a horse cock. Maybe that one. Oh, toilet cam footage revealed. Well, then it would be Ralph that would show up first. Then that would be Ralph. He'd be here instantly. If that was the title, not Edelwolf. Edelwolf would be the second person to show up. I don't know. Somebody, Edelwolf is an. I don't know why he didn't choose Edelwolf if he's a rampant furry. Sounds a little more alpha than Edelwolf. Like a dull wolf, right? Instead of, you know, Edelwolf. Like he's out on the prowl, he's hunting. Edelwolf goes full Kino, or Kino. Edelwolf goes full Carol the Wolf. Mr. Hands, also known as Edelwolf. Alive, question mark? I kind of like that one. I'm going to be honest with you, chat. I do like that one. That's got a nice ring to it. Edelwolf equals Carol, question mark? I think the question mark really would it's what sells it. From Alinar for 0.1 Oodles, or Beelzebucks. Ruff has Google Alerts set up for anything containing shit. I'd believe it. I think we'd all believe it. You know, I gotta say, I've been enjoying the Mornings with Metokur thing. Over here on Cozy. Oh my god, Michael Alberto, get out of my head. He's controlling me now. He's making me say things to make them madder at him. Michael Alberto, why are you restreaming this? Deep cover on Cozy, it's just gonna make them mad. Over here on Odyssey, being able to say what I like, it's pretty enjoyable. It's a lot more freeing, a lot more free-flowing. It's giving me ideas. Like, we can go back to the autistic dating show one. I want to do, like, an incel special. I want to do like a detransitioning stream. Now, I don't know if I can go full surgical videos on you. That probably is taking it a step too far. But we'll get right up to the edge. And I'll show you what it looks like, what Hellraiser should have been. Just flayed open organs. Except it's in the real world, and everybody's loopy on estrogen. Oh, more Kemet shit? God, I miss the Kemet stuff. Those guys are fun as fuck. Just all the shit that YouTube has shut down, that you can't talk about over there? That you're free to say whatever you want over here? You can watch whatever you want? It's pretty great, I'm going to be honest with you. Gore threads? I don't know if we can go full gore threads on this. But we could do a How the Sausage is Made 2.0 chat. That is a possibility. Maybe even watch like we'll do like one episode of Photon for old time's sakes. Just one. Where our favorite little guy gets blown up by a grenade or some shit. Oh, what do we have here? Are you linking me to a video or a chat for your 0.01 oodles? Oh, I know what this is. Holy fuck. I'm willing to play this one. Flaming Poop Rub. I know exactly what this clip is. Now, I don't know if everybody in chat has seen this. Is this the one with the... Well, I guess asking, is this the one with the autistic guy playing video games? That's like just... That's the default. We don't even need to ask that. Is this Poopy Butt? Are we going to watch the Poopy Butt fucking video? Where mommy has to step in because somebody's been a dirty boy? Let's take a look, if it's what I'm thinking it is.
Demetrius, get off the game, go to the bathroom, and take a shit. Now.
Hey.
Bathroom and shit now. Go to the bathroom and take a shit. I can smell you. Get off.
Hey.
Okay, let's break this down. It's only a minute long. We're 12 seconds in, but we've already... 17 seconds in. We've already got so much to work with. So here's Demetrius, your typical cozy TV streamer, who... He smells... The shit is inside him. He hasn't shit himself. He's not Ross. He didn't poop himself. But the smell is so strong. The gases have built up so much in his tummy that his mother, from half a house away, can smell it. I want you to picture his mother sniffing the air like a bloodhound, galloping into his room, trying to find the source of the eggs. Where is that sulfur smell coming from? Demetrius! And demanding he takes a poop. Because it's so bad.
Go to the bathroom!
You know.
Go to the bathroom. I can smell you shitting yourself. Get up and go to the bathroom. Now!
No.
Get up and go to the bathroom!
Not yet.
Go to the bathroom! You're shitting yourself!
Not yet.
Go to the bathroom! You're shitting yourself!
Not yet. No.
I will rip everything apart. I swear to God. Go to the bathroom!
Not yet.
You're shitting yourself!
Not yet.
You're shitting yourself! Poop is coming out of your fucking asshole!
Okay. Let's revise our position. Maybe he is pooping himself. But that leaves me with more questions. Like, can she see it? Is he sitting in his gamer chair and he's just naked and he's just letting it come out as he plays? It's like a pee jar. Is he squatted over like an old masonry jar or something? And it's just, you can hear the thuds hitting every time he hits an objective in Mafia 3. And he keeps saying, not yet, not now, I'm waiting. What are you waiting for? What do you mean not now? What's the checkpoint you're looking forward to that's going to let you defecate properly and not on your gaming chair? This is somebody who's probably got a lot of Xbox achievements because he really knows how to game. It's true gamer spirit here.
Go to the bathroom!
Not yet.
Go!
Not yet. No.
Go to the goddamn bathroom.
Not yet.
No. Demetrius not going to go poop right now. No. Amazing. Welcome to the speedrunning content. Oh. Yeah, I'm dying to know exactly what he's waiting for. It's another one. Is this another gamer doesn't want to take a poop thing? Let's take a look here. One second. Let me get it loaded up. I don't even know what the fuck this is. It's a streamable link. Let's take a look. Let's take a look here. Let me check it. Let me check it first to make sure there's not dolphin porn. Okay, there's no dolphin porn. I think we're good.
A real job. You can't just play video games every day. I go to work, you're playing games. I come home after 12 hours, you are still playing games. You don't even help with bills. You need to get a job. I come home every day crying. We're gonna lose the house. Where are the cats gonna go? Jordan, for real.
That's that true gamer attitude. All right, you need to shut up, bitch. All right, I've got goals to accomplish in my game. Sitting there in Sonic. Feels rigged. Feels fake. I'm going to be honest with you, but probably a good recreation of something real. He's going fast. He's got to go fast. Yes, I do agree with you, Mutt. It does have a very fake feel to it. I prefer my autistic pants shitters to be real. Okay. I have a quality bar that I like to set for degenerates on the internet. So stuff like that idiot pooping himself or that one kid that got caught by their mom jacking off, that was funny as fuck. As I don't know why he'd keep the video rolling or the audio of his Discord call while his mother chastises him. I have no idea, but that felt very real. There was another one. It wasn't in Mafia. I think it's like an old Cloud Gaming or Cloud 78654 or whatever, where his mom like beats him on stream. Like you can hear him getting hit and screaming. That's entertaining. I'm willing to take a look at a few of these. Here's two pennies and watch a clip. All right, let's what clips are we watching here? I'll be the judge of that. I'll be the judge. Oh, the Sam Hyde stuff. I've seen that. I've seen the other people have covered this. The one where they all go to TwitchCon. And everybody keeps going up to Hassan saying, "You're going to fight Sam Hyde." And Hassan is a little bitch. He's a big, well, not a big bitch. He's a little bitch. Terrified. Terrified that he's going to get fucked with. Oh, is this the Amberlance one? Oh, we can watch the Amberlance clip. I'll put that one on. Hold on. If this is actually the Amberlance.
Yeah, girl.
Oh, he lifted her ass off the ground. That's like an exorcism. It's like he called on Jesus for a moment and she levitated. Threw her ass out, threw her shit out too. I thought that was the Amberlance clip. Where the guys are fucking with somebody. So she had black girl magic. I don't know if that's black girl magic. But he sure shit knocked her out. Right on her ass. Rocked her block with that one. Oh my god. You know, these are a fun way to do a Saturday morning. Watching people get beaten. Watching the despair of Walmart workers. watching Ethan Ralph get angry he wasn't invited to play video games. Celebrating Rumper Dumper Liberation Day. It's all very good. It's all very good. And yeah, we'll also get eventually to Acer Thorn and the other fat fuck that's running around DMCing everybody as it kind of plays itself out. But yeah, I good vibes going ahead. for the kind of fucked up shit we're going to be able to watch. Which means I finally can start harvesting videos from websites that aren't YouTube. But I've got to find ones that are still up. Because a lot of the websites that had really great videos don't even exist anymore. So I've got to try to find, like, mirrors of it up on maybe BitChute or, like, Vimeo sometimes has shit that's hidden away. It'll just be kind of, out there, hidden under titles, locked away as, like, an internet memory. And if you stumble on it, that's great, and you can watch it. And if not, well, fuck you, tough luck. So, but we'll do this every Saturday, 9 a.m. Until I drop dead or get bored with it. We'll see. But I think we got some fun shit coming up. Let me make sure. I want to make sure I didn't miss any oodles here. I'm still learning Odyssey. I know some people complain about the app or the desktop. I'm just trying to make sure that I'm not missing my oodles. From Barlow's PhD, Walmart plays songs on its radio at the store, and I remember they played Blink 182, All the Small Things, and I shit you not, they censored the line, "Work sucks." I could believe it. From Buck Mulligan, Bin Laden was right. The great Satan must be destroyed. I'm going to guess these are in relation. These must have been ones I missed for the Walmart shit. Yeah, Zyklon Weed, maybe shooting up Walmart is justified. I could imagine the employees not having the best time in the world. Is that a sticker? I don't know what that is, Mr. Wukong. I mean, it's $5. $5 is $5, but... Do they do animated sticker? Oh, fuck. Do you think we can get dancing jellies back on this fucking place? I wonder if I asked them if they just do the stream me jellies. Little dancing blobs. Or do they already exist here? That's like the one thing I miss. Is that little dancing ball of blubber was fucking great. Dancing puddings. There we go. Blobs, puddings, whatever. Little blubber balls. I want the dancing puddings back. I wonder if we can, and moon crickets. Moon crickets and pudding. Do you think they think I'm insane? If I email Moloch. If I email Moloch at Odyssey HQ and I'm like, can I get some moon crickets and some pudding emojis, emoticons? Do you think they'd do it? From Mr. Kill Everything. Damn it, Nick. I don't think you'll ever do Turkey Man stream ever. Fruitcake. Oh, we will get to it. Oh, we will get to it. I wonder where I'd even do it. You know, I'm going to go for it. I'm going to see if we can get that ready for the next time. I'm going to see if I can get that ready for the next time. I want my little puddings. People saying Monograph is back. Okay. I thought him and Agent 79 of the Secret Society were having like a super internet war for a while there. Did he win? Is Agent dead? Did Monograph take his fucking head? Why is there a $3 sticker of Bill Clinton and a dress? You know, this website's got some charm to it. And there we go with Epstein Island as well. Perfect. All right, so let's end out the stream. What are we going to end out the stream on? Let me think. Well, I mean, you know, since I looked for this fucking song last time, I'm going to play it again. It still annoys me that I couldn't find it. I had to have, like, people send me, like, oh, I think I know what you're talking about. Maybe it's this. And then a few people finally got it. But again, chat, I want you to pee for pray for Nick Fuentes, who's currently in the emergency room suffering an overdose of chromium and lithium from eating batteries at the medical advice of Groypers. It's tragic. But today is Rumper Dumper Liberation Day. And so let's let that song play us out. We're praying for you, buddy. We're praying that you're going to be living your best life once they get that heavy metal poisoning out of your blood.
There's nothing wrong with being a f***ing. If you want to take it up the ass, then that's okay. There's nothing wrong with being a f***ing f***ing.
I mean, man, just come out the closet.
Cause as long as you say no homo, it's not gay. I said it's not gay. If the balls don't touch it, if they do, that's okay. Cause there's nothing wrong with being a fucking faggot.
Little bitch.
There's nothing wrong with being a faggot.
Fucking faggot.
If you wanna take it up the ass, that's fine with me. There's nothing wrong with being a dick sucking fudge packing faggot. Cause as long as you say no homo, it's not gay.